working rules for solving linear programming problem by graphical method when feasible reason is unbounded. Now I have drawn a figure here. A graph represents unbounded area. It is going like this to the infinite point. Okay, so this type of reason is called unbounded area. So now what new things you are going to face, let's discuss. Now step one, as we have done in the previous part, for the bounded area few steps will be going same. Now draw the half planes of all constants given in the problem, linear programming problem. Step 2, in the step 2 what we have done, it make the common area unbounded area shaded, in the feasible region. Now feasible unbounded areas, okay, that is called feasible unbounded areas. Now this is the feasible unbounded area. Make the unbounded area shaded in the feasible region by the lines. Step number 3, we have to find all the coordinates. Now step number 3, find all the coordinates of all the vertices of unbounded region. Step 4. Now in the step 4 what we have to find, the given maximize or minimize values. Okay, step number 4, find the value of the objective function z is equal to ax plus by at each point of unbounded region. For example, here we are having this point, we are having this point. Okay, so here we can write it P, Q, R and S. These are the points. Okay, now after this, these are the all the steps were the previous steps. Okay, so find the values of the objective function z is equal to ax plus by at each point of the feasible unbounded region. Now let A represents the maximum value and B represents the minimum value of z in the feasible unbounded region. Now, what to do when we are having unbounded area? For the bounded area, we got whether it is a minimum or a maximum, but now here still we are on the mid of the answer. Okay, so what extra we have to do it for the bounded unbounded part? Now let's discuss it. Now step 5, find the value of ax plus by is greater than a. A is maximum and find the value of, now we have to do something more efforts. We have to find the value of ax plus by is greater than a. A is maximum. Okay. For the maximum part, the a represents the maximum value. So we have to find the values of ax plus by is greater than a, where a is maximum and represent the dotted line on the same graph. Now this is what, when we are having, when a is the maximum. Okay, so now we are having maximum value of z is equal to ax plus by is a. Okay, now a is the maximum value of z if the open half plane determined by ax plus by is greater than a. A is the maximum value of z if the open half plane determined by ax plus by is greater than a has no point common. Has no point common. Then it represents the maximum value. Otherwise, otherwise, now what otherwise represents? Otherwise, what otherwise means? Here we have written determined by ax plus by is greater than a has no point in common. They are having no point in common. Otherwise, I am writing in the bracket, if common points are there, then if common points are there, then no maximum value exists. Now once again, let me tell you once more, we have got, as we have done the four points, first 4 points with the bounded area. Now after plotting the points on the graph paper, we came to know that it is the unbounded region. When it is unbounded region, then again, once again, we have to use, if the question is for the maximum, find the maximum value, then we have to put ax plus by is greater than a. Okay, then we have to solve it, we have to find the coordinates, and then we have to represent in the form of the dotted line on the same graph. We have to represent here only. Okay, now maximum value of z, we have taken it is a. Now A is the maximum value of Z if the open half plane determined by AX plus BY is greater than A has no common point, then it is maximum, otherwise it has no maximum value. Now what this is, what this represents. Now suppose we are having this point as a A, okay. Now the solution part for this value, solution part for this value, it represents like this. Suppose it represents like this. It means this line is not going inside the feasible area, unbounded feasible area, okay. So it is maximum. Now this is maximum. Maximum exists, but if this lines enters like this, anywhere, any side, if it enters like this, then no maximum for this part. If it enters in the feasible area, no maximum. If it does not enter in the feasible area, then it is a maximum, okay. So this lines in the black represents this part. Is it clear? So now okay, now same, now step 6, for minimum value, solve and find AX plus BY is less than B, because B was a minimum. We have taken B represents minimum. For the minimum value now, solve and find AX plus BY is less than B and plot on graph paper. Same graph. On the same graph. Now B is the minimum value of Z. Now B is the minimum value of Z if the open half plane determined, if the open half plane determined by AX plus BY is less than B has no point common, otherwise there is no minimum value. Same thing. Now I am not repeating this line again, okay. So same meaning. Now suppose here it is B. Now suppose this is B, and on solving the objective function Z we came to know, or on solving we came to know that B is the minimum point, and in the question it was asked for the minimum value. Now what this means, on solving this part, if the dotted line goes like this without touching the feasible area, without touching the unbounded feasible area, then it has a minimum value. If it enters inside it, then it has no minimum value. So this was all about the unbounded feasible area.